This will be interesting. Here come the world champions right now in second place as they were a year ago when they wowed us with an amazing performance to win European gold. But Paul, we watched them in practice, and even skating half the program, she seemed out of breath and out of condition.
Well, Chris, they have had a year full of problems. She's had the flu, he has had the flu, he has had a back problem. And when you combine those together, it causes you not to have the quality training time that you might normally like to have going into an Olympic Games. And we'll just have to see how well she handles that situation here this evening.
I noticed on the warm-up prior to this skate, she's having difficulty in her single jumps. And there we have it. She pulled out of the triple toe loop, and that's exactly what she did in the warm-up.
Later in this program, they have a side-by-side double axel plan, and in talking to their coach, Tomina Moscovina, she indicated that if they did the triple toes, they would not attempt the double axel. We'll have to wait and see.
Very nice throw triple toe loop.
It's unfortunate that she's had the difficulties she's had out there, because this is the kind of program where if everything doesn't go just right, it really takes the edge off the performance, especially in the type of program they're trying to skate here this evening. Very lyrical, very musical, and when you fall, it really breaks the image that you're trying to portray. She continues to knock off the throws, though, and again, a very nice one executed there. Aside from the mistakes that they did make, her mistakes in her solo jumps, it was a strong performance. However, not nearly to the level that we saw last year of the same program in Munich at the World Championships, which earned them their title.
Well, speaking with their coach, Tamara, she did say that they aren't at their the top level that they want to be yet. They still have 2 weeks to go to the Olympics. Here's a look at that throw triple toe loop. Very solid. One of their Nike moves.
Here we're going to look at the side-by-side double axel that she doesn't execute well. But again, as you mentioned, Barb, they're really not where they want to be at this point.
Still is a terrific crowd pleaser, but after seeing it the way it was skated at the World Championships, it's a little bit of a letdown when we don't see it executed perfectly. There's a look at the Protopopovs, the legendary Soviet couple. Going into this year, 25 of the last 27 pairs gold medals have gone to Soviet skaters. That streak will end, but perhaps CIS will start a new streak. And you must wonder what Brasseur and Eisler are thinking, 2 weeks away from the Olympics and seeing their arch rivals not at their best.
Well, not only that, Chris, but for Mishkatunik and Dmitriev, this is two performances that we've seen here at the Europeans and at La Ligue, where they did not skate up to the standard that we have seen them at previous competitions.
Here come the marks. 5-4 from the British judge, Natalia. Her reaction, I guess she's happy about that, but I'm sure deep inside not happy with the performance. Up to a 5-8 from the CIS judge. Second set of marks have always been higher. Look, there's a 6 from the Italian judge. The first perfect score of the European Championships. 5-9 to 5-8, so the gold medal still may be in their grasp. And I think they're a little surprised that it is.